You're on tour with Gotthard. Do you know the band before?
Sure.
Where from?
North Maryland. But I think Gotthard was very special because it's like an icon for Switzerland, so everybody knows.
And how it came that you're here now?
Because we have our manager is the same people. So we work on it and
so you're really happy about it? You play
absolutely.
Today. It's your first time here?
You mean in Switzerland?
Yes.
No, we played before 2 or 3 times, but very small place.
Okay, and you were support act for many famous bands like Alice Cooper or the Kaiser Chiefs. What was for you the current peak of your career? What was the highlight?
I don't know, because be a super band, it's be a guest, but in the same time, it's not your show, it's not your career.
Yeah.
It's just an opportunity to do something or to say, hey, we're here. But it's not like, hey, everybody, we are the fire, you are here for us.
Yes.
So, for example, now in Christmas,
yeah.
We go in Spain, in an island called Palma de Mallorca. And we play there, and everybody knows the fire. I don't know why.
Where are you playing there?
In a quite small place, but for 500-600 people, and called 180.
Okay.
And it's a crazy place because after midnight, became in a very a different kind of club because it's like I don't know for. Transvestite gay people. It's amazing, really.
Like the whole picture show.
Yeah. Before midnight, it's a rock. It's rock ambience.
Yeah.
You know? After midnight, it's yeah, it's quite grand. It's crazy.
So how many times you have played there?
In Palma, yes. 3 times, four times.
Yeah. Okay. Okay. So tell me something about your new album, Abracadabra.
It's special album. It's magic, of
course.
Because,
okay, quite special.
Because after 3 years from the first record called Overdrive, it was like a second step, and it's very hard because we made a lot of mistake and we split with somebody. An ex-team player is gone 2 years ago. And so find a new director, find new songs, find new energy, find new everything. And now, have the CD in my hands. It's like, damn, wow, it's amazing, it's magic. So, it's very
interesting. How long have you worked on this CD?
3 years.
3 years? Okay, and since when the fire started, when you came together?
2005.
Okay.
But I was in a popular ska called Man in Italy, and the rest of the band was another band called Nambos, but very different type of music, because Nambos was a punk rock band and I was in a ska called Man. And we decided to change everything because I was really full of punk rock stuff and this kind of attitude, and they say, I want to change everything in my life, and they say to me the same. So of course it was magic.
You were quite interesting to work together.
Yeah, they said to me, we want to change music. Yeah, we are very destroyed after 10 years of punk rock, and they said the same. So we can play together. I said, of course. And it was like born again, reborn.
Magic, great, something new. And on your CD you covered a song from Frank Sinatra. How does it came? Why you covered Frank Sinatra?
Well, it's a long story because in my personal career, I made a record without a swing band from the movie called Goodfellas, like the movie. and I was the guest, the record called Ollie meets the Goodfellas, like in the 50s. And my passion for swing and jazz music was the beginning of this song and this idea. And I said, I'm a big fan of Frank Sinatra and Michael Bublé and stuff like that. And this kind of, that kind of melodies and singer approach. But I'm a rock singer, so it was very strange opportunity for me singing that way.
Yeah.
Did the others
were okay with this?
Yeah, of course. And I said to the rest of the band, I'm being fired. I want to try to make a different cover, not a song from the 80s, for example, like Marilyn Manson or every rock band in the world. And I said, I want to make some different stuff, like Frank Sinatra. Yeah, of course, Frank Sinatra, it's stupid. No, believe me. It's not from Frank Sinatra, it's from Liza Minnelli. It's really powerful. And if you listen to something, a movie, you can feel the power of that song. Because it's crazy. It's more power than a rock song. It's a little bomb in between, and in the end it's exploding, of course. And we decide to try to do something like a rock arrangement like Queen in the 80s, very sweet, very smooth, and was an experiment. And after this first experiment, everybody started to say, hey, it's not so bad.
And so you're going to make this again? Have you planned for that?
What do you mean?
Did you have another song from Frank Sinatra?
No, I don't think so. But I want to try to put some jazz approach in our music. I mean, different chords, maybe distorted, but yeah. Jazz approach.
Okay. Sounds good. Good. Thank you very much.